Hi, I'm Rob Williamson, and I scored Midnight Meat Train along with Johanna Skibilke. Looking back on scoring Midnight Meat Train, I really wanted to take the lineage of horror genre filmmaking in the theme aspect of the score and try to get that 4 or 5 note theme and have it reoccur over and over in the film. I think I found most of the inspiration, oddly enough, from someone like Philip Glass, who just his minimalism approach to music. And I think Johannes and I really tried to keep it minimal and tried to really accentuate each instrument and not layer too much on top of each other. We really just approached this film reel by reel. He would take a reel and I would take a reel, and then we would get all the way through the film, and he seemed to have a couple themes, I would have a couple themes, and then we would exchange those themes and try them in different places. And we just kept going through the film like that, like 3 or 4 times, until we really like refined it to just this one theme for Mahogany. Writing music for Mahogany, the main character in Midnight Meat Train, was really fun because he's so vicious and he's so put together at the same time. He's very Asian in his dressing and the way that he would clean after he would kill someone. Just very orderly, so it was great to write super intense, heavy, scary music, but also keep it elegant and like precise. I started out in music in Seattle, Washington, playing in a band called My Name. It was sort of a prog punk band, and we put out a bunch of records on CZ Records. From there, I just started really getting into computer programming and electronic music, which led into scoring films. A friend of mine in Seattle was making an independent film called Dandelion. He asked me to co-write the script with him, which I did. It turned out great. And he knew I was a musician as well, so I started, as we were writing the script, I started writing pieces of music that I thought would work really well, just because I knew the vibe so well. And he ended up loving the music that I wrote, so I ended up scoring Dandelion, and that was pretty much my first major film that I scored. I was approached by Lakeshore to score Pathology, and they had heard my score for Dandelion a few years back and really thought that the sort of soft ambient approach that I had with that really accentuated the characters in the film, and some of the characters in Pathology I think were similar to the characters in Dandelion, and they saw that. But they wanted it to be a little bigger, I think, as well, which I was up for the challenge. And also I was approached by the director of Pathology, who had worked with another composer named Johanna Skibilke, and he also wanted him to do music for the film as well. And he's a very well-trained orchestrator. With Pathology, the characters were very complex, and I think in order to nail the characters in that film, we really did need the orchestra just to get all the subtleties of the swells and the timbre of the strings and everything that just really nailed those characters. Whereas in Midnight Meat Train, I think it was just a really sort of cold film, really metallic, and just really synth-based. As a composer and a filmmaker, I think I value the opinion that music really should be a third character in a film, and I really try to strive to get to that point with music.